Okay, so let's get started. Today in this webinar, I'm going to talk about how you can automate your PeopleSoft testing using a PeopleSoft test framework. And this is the agenda for today's webinar. I'm going to give an introduction about who we are and what we do, where we are based out of and on that, and some of the testing challenges that you face today using manual testing, and a bolt-on that is developed by Astute that's called FastTest, and how this can be integrated with PTF, and how it can help you leverage your testing, and a quick demo of what FastTest is, how does it work, and how you can see the live reporting, etc., using the bolt-on tool FastTest, and the implementation approach, the timeline methodology, and so on, followed by the question and answers. So if you do have any questions at any point in time, you can ping us in the chat and we'll take them towards the end. So let me just go ahead and explain you about who we are. So we, Astute Business Solutions, are based in Pleasanton, California. And we have our offices in Dallas and Madison.
Are you able to get in?
I'm sorry. I would request everyone to please go on mute. And Astute has a global presence in Dallas, Madison. We have our offshore offices in Hyderabad, India, and also in Toronto, Canada. And we are an Oracle Gold partner and a standard cloud partner. And our industry expertise is across industries like healthcare, banking, education, and government. And we've also been working with nonprofit organizations. And Astute is also a Velocity partner and an OCI reseller. And we do have a solution that's available on Oracle Cloud Marketplace.
Tell you what.
And some of the consulting services that we offer are the PeopleSoft upgrades on OCI and also the PeopleSoft automated testing using FastTest and lift and shift to OCI. So all of your workloads that's on-prem is moved to OCI, and the implementation of DR for PeopleSoft and upgrades and pumps and tools upgrade on OCI and fluid implementation. And also the PeopleSoft implementation. Say suppose a customer is implementing a new module or a workflow or integration or any enhancements or Elasticsearch. So we do take care of all of that. So let's go about some of the testing challenges that you face during manual testing. So some of these challenges that we hear from time to time from customers are, it is mostly error prone, you know, because it is being tested manually, you know, some of the errors might just get, you know, like you may not recognize it and oversee them, and the time spent on it. So of course, definitely if you're doing it manually, the amount of time that is spent on doing manual testing is huge. And also the testing is not current. So I mean to say that in case if you have your manual scripts, unless you update them yourself manually, you will not have them current, and inconsistent data. So every time a manual testing is being done, the data has to be keyed in manually, and you know, we might encounter some errors and the data might not be consistent all through, and the defects. So there is, you know, in order to track the defects, even the defects have to be entered into the defect tracking systems manually and reporting. So with manual testing, so far from some of the customers, what we have heard is that they would have to run some queries and download them into Excel, apply the filters, do some sorting, you know, and all of that, and get the report to the higher management and the test coverage. So since this is being done manually, so probably, you know, at least we have not seen from any customers that they're testing full end-to-end process or there is 100% coverage of the test scripts. And let's see how may I please request everyone to go on mute? Thank you. And let's see how FastTest can address all of these challenges. With FastTest powered by PTF, almost 80% of the testing will get automated. So the rest 20%, if you ask me what are these things that cannot be automated, so if there is anything that is outside of PeopleSoft, say for example, if you have integrations with a third-party system and all that, so that is something that PTF cannot automate. So except that, almost pretty much everything that you do on your PeopleSoft page can be automated. And the useful metrics. So FastTest also has a dashboard which gives you the live reporting. So based on your testing, you know, like how many tests have been run, how many have gone to pass, how many have failed, and you know, if there are any defects raised for it, so how many defects are pending, how many are being worked on. All of these metrics are available one single place. And reduced timelines. So since the scripts are automated and they can be used over and over again for each of your test cycles, this will definitely reduce the amount of time you spend on testing. So this can be used to test your bug fixes after the upgrade, or if you have updated any PUMs or your regression testing, tags updates, and pretty much everything. And reduced effort. So FastTest also has the, you know, inbuilt data mining feature with which the user need not enter the data manually into the automated script. So the automated script is built in such a way that it goes and picks up the relevant data that it has to use for testing purpose. So here, the time spent on preparing the data for your testing is also reduced. And FastTest also comes with a defect management tool where after you run your scripts, you can log a defect and track what the defect is, who is working on, and what's the progress on that. So let's see, you know, how exactly FastTest works and so on. So FastTest is a bolt-on tool that is built by Astute, and this resides in People Tools as a part of PTF. So just like you access any of your folders in your PeopleSoft, FastTest is also in a similar way. When you log in to your PeopleSoft application, you can see FastTest and you can access all the menu from there. And FastTest also comes with a pre-built test library. So for each of the tools version that you're on and the PUM release, we will also give up FastTest pre-built test library for the standard business processes. And as I mentioned, FastTest comes with the feature of data mining, and also if you want to run your script at the end of the day, say suppose you do not want to sit and monitor the script, you know, for hours together when it is running, you can start it at the end of the day, you can go back home, and when you come back in the morning, it would have executed all the scripts and you can see the report on the dashboard. And FastTest comes with defect tracker, and you have a dashboard with live reporting, and we can also build the custom test scripts for your business processes as well. Okay, let me come to this. And let's see, I explained to you what FastTest is and what are the different features that it has, and now let's see why FastTest is needed. So if you say that, yeah, we already have PTF, but I want to know, you know, like why I need FastTest on top of PTF. So FastTest is a bolt-on tool, as I said. So it is very easy for you to migrate from one instance to the other. You know, it actually gets saved, stored as a metadata in your PeopleTools table. So So just like the way you move your projects, your customizations from one instance to the other, even this can be done the same way. And it is an online, easy to use interface. So for the people who have already seen PTF, you know, the client, how it works and how it looks. So it is, you know, it's more like an app designer, which requires a little technical knowledge as such. But FastTest is a very easy to use online interface. And it has live reporting dashboard. So you do not have to run any queries, apply filters, do sorting to get the report. So all the reports are available at place in real time. And FastTest is an end-to-end automation solution for your business processes. And with one click, you can execute as many tests as you want in sequence. And FastTest also comes with the defect management, which is not available out of the box in PTF. So now I'm going to hand it over to my colleague, Nadeem, for a quick demo.
Thank you, Supriya. Anyway, good afternoon. Good morning to everyone. Okay, this is the FastTest dashboard that we are looking at. It is a collection of all the reports, and it shows the test and defect metrics information, and it allows to monitor the progress of any of the test cycle. All the reports that we see on the dashboard, for example, the execution report, the status report, the shell test report, and other reports, it gives very accurate, very dynamic, and very up-to-date results. On the left-hand side, we can see some of the functionality which is within the FastTest automation tool. Example, we have a process sequencer, how you can sequence the test as we want. You have the test case generator, how you want to generate the test cases in an automated fashion. You can execute tests, you can schedule tests, and then we have defect manager also. So this is the dashboard, but let's start with some of the functionalities. So right now what you see is a fluid FastTest manager self-service homepage. In this page, the fluid tiles have been configured based on the roles of the of a testing manager. And for example, manager can view the test execution logs, he can manage the requirements, he can view the dashboard reports, he can manage 10 test logs and FastTest automation tools and much more. We also have a fluid page for FastTest, which is for self-service. So the configuration of the tiles, these have been done based on the role of a tester. For example, tester can find the test. They can work on the defects that has been assigned to them, and they can execute the test as well. And they have some functionality for the automation tools also. So the idea is that with the help of the fluid tiles, fluid functionality, navigation collections, we can personalize the FastTest fluid homepages based on the roles. It could be based on a tester, it could be based on a business analyst or a business user or the testing manager. So based on all the roles, all these tiles can be configured and presented in the form of a self-service page. So let's see a few capabilities for the FastTest product. Here we have find test. So this feature allows to search for any test and perform various functions. For example, if I just go to a root folder So within this folder, which is there in the PTA, we have some tests, some shell test over here. And we have the related actions. So from here, we can view the logs of the past test runs. You can load the data here. You can run here and view or edit the test driver. Just for example, if I go and click on view logs, so for this shell test, all the previous runs with the details come over here, and it gives the test results. It gives the folder, the test name, which test case was done, when it was done, who ran it. So you get all these details over here. And from this log, you also get the functionality to create a defect from here. You just select one of the logs, create a defect, and the defect tracker will open. And we'll cover that in a bit. Another functionality is you can run a test from here. If you just click on run, you can get the details. It gets populated, which test is being run, and you can save and continue. And it can run this test online, and we don't need the PTF to execute this test. The other functionality is view or edit the test. So this test has been created in PTF with this set of data. Now today, if you want to come and change the data and you want to, for example, you want to run for a different business unit, you just go ahead and change the business unit and save this test. So the test gets saved with this new set of values, and you can execute it from here. This is how you can, like, any test which has been created, you can create a new test case, or you can edit the same set of values for that test. Going back to the homepage, we have a tile with execute test. Execute test functionality allows to execute a PDF test or a shell test from this PeopleSoft application. It gives you the functionality, like flexibility, to run it right now, or you can even schedule it for a later run. For example, if I want to have it execute from here, I just select this. Execute ID is similar to a run control, which is needed for to run any process. We say we are running it from here, and then you give the folder name, you give the test which you want to run, you give the test case. If it has multiple, you can select the test case and just say save and continue. So with this, you get a option to run this, and before running this, we need to have an execution options. This is needed from the point that for against which instance you need to run this. So this is stored within the application, all the options, whether you want to run it in a set instance, dev instance, which user ID will be created, which user ID will be used to run that test. So those things are stored in the execution option, and you just execute test or save batch. If you execute this test, this will run as of now. And if you save this batch, you can later schedule it to run it at a later stage. So let's say no. Going back here. So one other functionality we have is the manage of test logs. This functionality allows to search for the test logs based on a search criteria. This can be based on a module, based on a range of dates, based on the test outcomes. I say demo and just select one shell, click on search. So this is similar to the earlier we saw the review test log from another tile, but this is the main navigation from where you can come and check this. So here I'll show you like how we can create a defect as well. So for this run, if you need to create a defect, you select this test and you select the item action, create defect, and click on go. So the defect manager opens up, and here we have like the few of the fields pre-populated. You can change, say the modules, it says PO, the test phase, it can be set, and issue description, just say login phase, and you can assign to any of the person, and then once assigned, you can change it to assign. And we have a PTF logs tab. So the PTF logs gets attached automatically when you are creating the defect from the review log page. So anyone who is working on this defect, he can go back, refer to this log to find the details for working. Then we have attachment functionality. Attachment is any attachment in the form of a screenshot or a manual script or a requirement document or any other document that will be beneficial for the business analyst to look into this defect, that can be attached over here. Then we have some user fields which has been kept like this for further integration. And you come and save this defect. So this defect gets saved, defect ID gets created. With the built-in email functionality, which is within the FastTest, the assignee of this test gets an email notification that a defect has been assigned for him for the further analysis and resolution. So all the fields which are related, like for you have priority, you have the folder structure, you have the severity, test phase, subject, everything is over here. What is the issue type, if it's configuration, clarification, any test ID, if you have want to map it with the any of the requirement documents, those can be added over here. So this was defect manager, and now when we are seeing the defect manager, let's see the manage defect styles. So this feature allows to view and track all the defects at one place. These are the defects which have got created. It gets a defect ID, modules, whatever we have entered in the defect manager, you can see it from here. And if you want to look into details, if you click any of these, it will open up the defect manager. And every time we update this, any field here, the assignee gets an email notification for the changes which has been made to this defect. Okay, so going back to the home page, there are some of the reports which are there on this home page. One of this is a test executions log status. This gives an overview of the execution log of the testing of the current PeopleSoft test cycle. And you can view it from here that how many has been passed, how many have been errored out. So if you click on this, this gives you the further details. And also you have the option to change it from the report style. If you want to have a different style, you can have these reports into different formats. And if you're looking at from a module perspective or a status perspective, and say, okay, how many have been what the status for the lease admin. You click on this and you get the details for the lease admin module. If you want to have a look on all the errors, you can just click on the status and the report gets updated dynamically. So back to the home page. One more report we have is the defect drill down report. This report gives the status of the defects with different filter options. Like you can filter it by severity, by priority, by module. If you further open this, so right now it's set to all. If I expand this, so this gives the further details, how many have been assigned, how many are new, what's the ready for retest, how many are resolved, and if I go here, we can again filter it dynamically. If you want to assign it, like see how many has been currently assigned, you can just look at the assigned one. And if you are like working on a triage meeting and you have to like assign it all the new test cases, you can go and look at the new ones. And if you click on this number, you can just see the further details on those defects, like which needs to be assigned and which needs.
Yeah, I waited 29 minutes. Hey, let's do it tomorrow then.
Just requesting everyone to go on mute, please. Thank you. So this is about the defect drill down report. And we go back to the home page. So these were like few of the reports that we have on our Astute home page. But as we saw earlier, we also have the dashboard, which gives the complete picture. And we have further reports on this. For example, we have a test execution report, we have a consolidated test report, we have shell test report. So the test execution report, if we talk about this, this gives the execution status of the scripts corresponding to different modules. This is based on the structure that we create and the PTF. You can drill down to any of these reports, any of these modules to see the further details. For example, if I click on lease admin, it opens up the details for all the tests which has been run for this module, and its status is there. And you also have a related action which says create defect. So for any of the errors, if you want, you can create the defects from this page also. So there are multiple tiles, multiple navigations from where you can do the same function. And this gives the complete picture for all the modules, how many total tests are there, how many have been run, how many have been passed, what's the status, whether fail, fatal error, warning. This color coding, yellow, green, and red, this has been done, configured based on the percentage execution. And this is very much configurable. If you just click on, say, personalize, and you say personalize thresholds, so you can change it, like at what percentage of execution you want to have the different colors. So these can be changed from here. And you can have like more thresholds also based on your requirement. This defect status report, again, this is that was on the fluid and this is placed on the dashboard. You get all the details based on your severity, based on your priority. If you expand this, then you get the details of assigned, new, ready for retest, resolve. You can just click on the details and it will show you the details of those execution, those status. And we coming back to the fastest tool. It's we have a functionality for the test case generator. This is a tool which creates multiple test cases based on your different sets of data. You don't need to go manually into the tool, into the PTF, and enter it manually. You can upload it from an Express sheet, or if you want to just have it one, you can enter the values from here. The idea is that you don't need to go back to your PDF tool and update the test there. Example, if I just click on this demo, sorry. Select my test, AP voucher. So we have the functionality to mass upload. Mass upload is downloading a template in spreadsheet and again adding the values and importing it back to the system. And if you have just one or two set of data, that can be added manually over here. So right now, if you see, we have this test and with multiple test cases, you can see one of five. So the second set has a different value. Third is test case two, fourth, and fifth. And if you want, you can just go ahead and add another one, saying test case six, and this is my invoice ID six, and I want today's date, which is 3/7/2019. Gross amount, I just changed 2000, and save it. So a new test case has been saved. So if one or two test cases are there, you can just do it from an individual test case load or a manual test case load. But if you are having like multiple set of data, that can be done during the with the help of a spreadsheet upload using the mass upload functionality. Another feature is the process sequencer. So this process sequencer lets you bundle up multiple tests together for a single click execution. So you create a sequence and run it in the evening. You can come back next day morning and you get the results for all. If you are running it like one test or one shell at a time, that normally is done in via PTF. So you have to run one at a time. But with this functionality, if you want, you want to have like click on multiple shells of the same module. For example, an AP business analyst can create his own personal sequence for, say, AP shells. Let's say AP shells, and the path I want to create in the demo, which module, I say, okay, accounts payables, and select the test. So when you are doing it via PTF, or you are doing execution, you can do one by one, but with the process sequencer, you can go and select if you want two, three, or just say select all. Click on OK, as selected test. So this is a sequence that will be created, and you can say save and continue. And again, an option of executing it now or executing it later. With the execution name, you select it, the CM admin, and say execute now or later. So what will happen is whenever this is being run, either now or later, it will run all those 11 shells at one by one in that sequence, the way we have just created. So you don't need to look like do it manually one by one. It can be created via sequence. Then we have a scheduled test. Schedule test allows to schedule any of the tests. For example, just now we saw the process sequencer and earlier we saw the execution of a test. If you have saved that batch file, what you can do is you can create a new schedule, give the batch file path from here, here the batch file path where you have saved on the system, and then give the begin date and begin time, at what time you plan to run that. And when you click on schedule batch file, at that time, at that date, the system will automatically run that file. So create a sequence, execute your test, and schedule it for later run. If you have more tests, schedule it for a weekend run. And then whenever you come back, you can get the details of all the tests in one shot. And I go to FastTest automation tool over here. One more piece is there, which is called library manager. So with this library manager, you can manage your library from here. So when I say manage library, what you can do is you can select any of the tests and you can assign it to a tester. You can copy this test between folders. You can move the test from one folder to another, and you can delete it from any test. So you say just select this test and you can assign it, copy it, delete it, or move it. So these things can be done from here as well. So I think this was FastTest, and a tool which is a test automation and the defect management, which like saves time by eliminating your manual testing. It reduces costs by speeding up the deployment and also minimizes the risk for the people's of deployment in the place. Thank you. Over to you, Supriya. Hey, Supriya, are you on mute by any chance? Okay, I think there is some technical glitch there with the audio. So this is what we saw on the FastTest. And it's a test automation tool, which is based on the PeopleSoft test framework. We just record a test using PTF and do a playback using the FastTest functionality. And it has a pre-built of test library. So what we have what we just saw a few of the tests, but we have a library of over 2,000 tests, which is across HCM, FSCM, and campus solutions. And we saw the test management tools, which includes your test manager, requirement manager, defect tracker, data mining. We have the test dashboard. It's both, everything is based on, like, we have on Fluid and we have on the Classic. And then we have the maintenance support with we do have managed services where we support the end-to-end solutions for the PTF and the FastTest tool. So these are some of the clients which are using FastTest. It is across all the industries. We have healthcare, we have staffing, we have government, we have education. So look, across the industry, this is being heavily used. Okay, I think, please let me know if you have any questions. We have an email. Let me try to have it in the chat. So if you have any questions, you can write to us at info@peastute.com and we'll get back to you. If you have any further questions, if you want to have any further detail kind of a presentation, or if you want to have a proof of concept, so anything like which is across, like, okay, so the question is, what is the typical time frame to implement FastTest? So this typical time frame is around 6 to 8 weeks, and it all depends on the number of shells, number of end-to-end scenarios that we create. So if there are, based on the scenarios, it ranges from 6 weeks to 8 weeks. And if someone is like wants beyond that, that is again like thinking we go up to 10 or 12 weeks. But the typical scenario on average, it's around 6 to 8 weeks.
Okay, and I see another question that it says like the fastest record defects into ALM. So we have a feature in FastTest which can be used to integrate with ALM and then Jira, Fire, and other testing tools. So yes, this can be integrated. And the next question I see is, does FastTest have APIs already created for HP ALM for having the defects in ALM? No, so we do not have an API already for that, but we do have a feature that can be used to integrate, and based on the third party system, the testing system that we are integrating, we can create the APIs for it. Okay, the next question is, will a recorded copy of this webinar and presentation be provided to the attendees? So yes, this PPT would be sent across to the attendees, and the webinar is available on our website and also on YouTube. And the next question that I see here is that, you know, can this be done as a proof of concept? Yes, so we can do a proof of concept and show you how your manual testing can be automated. You know, we can try to automate a few business scenarios for you and show you that. So any more questions, I can take them. So the next question I see is that, can FastTest be used to replace PTF? So the short answer is no, because FastTest is built on top of PTF. So the scripts that you have in PTF can be accessed, can be run, can be modified, and can be loaded. All that can be done using FastTest. But yes, so it still sits on top of PTF. And then this is not a bolt-on that will replace PTF. This will work with PTF. And the next question is, do you charge for the POC? So this is something that we can take offline. You can write to us at info@bstu.com, and, you know, we can take it from there. And the next question I see is that, like, do we have a pre-built for all of the pillars? The answer is yes, we do have a pre-built library for all of the delivered business processes that's available for HCM, for finance and campus solutions and others. So again, a question on the timeline of the POC and the jumpstart. So for a POC, I would say it would vary anywhere between from a week to 2 weeks, depending on the requirement that you have and the scope. And a typical jumpstart implementation plan would be around 8 to 12 weeks for each pillar. So the next question I see is that, how soon can the ROI be realized with this? So the short answer is with just your first testing cycle itself. So the scripts that are automated can be used right away with your next testing cycle to automate your testing. The next question I see here is that, are these the clients that you have implemented FastTest for? Yes, these are only some of the clients. You know, I mean, since I had to put all of the customers in just one slide, I have just squeezed them in. But we have done many, many implementations of FastTest. These are just probably the 20% of the customers that I've put in here. Does the application have the help feature similar to UFT? The application inbuilt does not have a help feature as such, but we are available, you know, for any questions or any support at any point in time. We still have 9 more minutes. I can take more questions.
So I see on another one that says, has it been implemented for healthcare industry? Yes, we do have many healthcare customers as well. So we have expertise across industries. Like we have implemented this for banking, financial services, healthcare, education, government, and nonprofit. Yeah. Okay, so the next question is this something that's available on cloud? That's a very good question. And yes, this is available on cloud. So it is also available on Oracle Cloud Marketplace for you. And yes, so FastTest can be deployed and it will function the same way as it works on on-prem. Okay, so if you do not have any more questions to me, and if you do have questions later, you can write to us at info@beastute.com and we will get back to you. And okay, I got another question from Drew. Does it mean you sell this as a subscription? So Drew, yes, we have multiple models. So based on your requirement and the scope, you know, we can actually work out which model works out better for you. Okay, and then thank you, everyone. If you have any questions, please do get back to us. You can write to us at info@bstu.com, and we will share the PPT of this webinar with the audience. Thank you so much. Have a great day.